Alviro Petersen hit a superb 100 as Lancashire kept themselves in the game on day 3 against Somerset. Lancashire started day 3 on 138 for 2, still 415 runs behind, but with 8 wickets still in hand. Petersen and Livingston were the not-out batsmen, and the early part of the session turned into a cover drive competition. The jury's still out on the winner of this one. Tired of stroking them majestically through the covers, Petersen tried his hand at an old-fashioned belt over the sight screen, and with positive results. Petersen passed 50 and continued to display a dazzling array of strokes. Not to be outdone, Livingston lofted a 6 of his own over the mid-on fence. Livingston too passed his half-century, but he departed shortly afterwards. Caught behind off Leach for 57, his partnership with Petersen worth 117. Croft was the new man in, and he kept the scoreboard ticking over, Lancashire going to lunch on 243 for 3. Batting 101 with Alviro Petersen continued after the break as he progressed towards 100. Croft was proving able support for the South African, who then brought up his 42nd career ton in style, launching Leach into the stands for 6, Lancashire kicking plenty of goals on day 3. Croft passed his 50 midway through the session, as Petersen meanwhile continued to send it to all corners of the ground. Somerset turned to Chris Rogers in an effort to shake things up, but Petersen was undeterred. He and Croft batted through the session to take Lancashire to tee on 360 for 3. Shortly after the interval, Petersen went past 150, a magnificent knock in the context of the match, keeping his side in the game deep into day 3 after Somerset's massive first innings total. However, Petersen's innings was to end shortly after that, caught by Treskothick off Grunewald for 155, the Somerset fielders showing their appreciation for the quality of Petersen's innings. Croft followed Petersen back to the shed shortly afterwards, caught by Allenby off Leach for 58. Proctor made 2 off 35 balls before he was trapped leg before by Overton. But Clark ensured that Lancashire would avoid the follow-on midway through the session. Clark was out to a good catch from Davis off Gregory for 16, and Jarvis fell shortly after, bowled by Gregory for 10. Kerrigan was the 9th wicket to fall, shortly before the close of play, caught by Hildreth off Gregory for a duck. Lancashire made it through to stumps with their last wicket still intact, finishing the day on 422 for 9, mostly thanks to a superb batting display from Alviro Petersen. Croft and Livingston also hit half centuries as Lancashire avoided the follow-on, and they'll resume on day 4, still 131 runs behind in the first innings, with 1 wicket in hand.